Hey guys, in this video we're going to look at the domain for two different equation types. And the first equation is in slope-intercept form, y equals 4x plus 3. And when you have an equation in this form, x is not in the denominator anywhere, so the domain is going to be all real numbers. You would express that domain in integral notation from negative infinity to positive infinity, and you would also use parentheses because infinities cannot be bounded. You do not have to graph this, but I will show you the graph so that you can see. To the left, you have an arrow that does extend indefinitely to negative infinity. The line is continuous, and on the right, you do have another arrow that extends to positive infinity. So it does make sense that the domain for this function is expressed as negative infinity to positive infinity. The second equation, y equals 27 over the expression x plus 9, has a denominator, and it also has x in the denominator. When this happens, you will have a restricted value for that x because the denominator is undefined at 0. So that means the expression in the denominator cannot equal 0. X plus 9 cannot equal 0. You can actually write that out and solve for x. This will give you the restricted value. If I subtract 9 from both sides and do the work, I will find that x cannot equal negative 9. That's one way to express the domain, but typically we have to express our domains in integral notation. To do that, it looks a little more complicated than it is, but basically it starts from negative infinity, goes up to negative 9, and then you'll use the union symbol, and then start at the negative 9 and go to positive infinity. You use parentheses around those negative 9s to indicate that negative 9 is not included in the domain. Parentheses mean you don't touch that value. You also use a union symbol to indicate that everything else, except for that negative 9, exists in the domain of that function. So what I'm going to do is show you the graph just so that you can see. Again, you do not have to graph this at all. All you have to do is identify the restricted value and write that in your integral notation. But here is the graph. It is a hyperbola, and on the left of the graph, you do have an arrow that extends indefinitely to negative infinity, and on the right, you have an arrow that extends indefinitely to positive infinity. And notice that where x is equal to 9, those little pieces of the graph will approach negative 9 indefinitely, just like the parentheses indicate. It won't ever reach it, it will never touch it, and it will never cross it. So think of it that way, and you can express your domain in integral notation when you have a fraction in this manner. Here are two more examples. You can go ahead and pause the video and then come back to check your answers. Okay, for these, the first equation is in slope-intercept form, so that will have a domain of negative infinity to positive infinity. And the second, in this case, you have a denominator where x cannot equal positive 3. So the integral notation will range from negative infinity to positive 3, and then there will be a union with positive 3 to positive infinity. I do hope you enjoy practicing this skill.